I'm Janelle and this is toDIYfor. So this week I thought that I would tackle my patio space. We're going to be doing a little bit of an upgrade. Now if you have been following along my channel, maybe you have already seen my patio makeover that I did last year. It was a new space then. I did a complete makeover for $150. It included a really great IKEA hack in which I built an L-shaped bench for our patio. I will leave that linked for you below if you want to check it out, give you some ideas. But this year, well, I found that we kind of just didn't really have a great table space. It's quite tight, but what I'm going to be doing is building a sort of table shelf so that we can have a space to put our drinks and to put snacks and whatnot out there. And it's going to be mounted and hang on our railing. We're just gonna see how this goes. So let's get into the DIY. So I'll be honest with you, when I recorded that, I had no idea what the plan was, but I went out and bought this wood. Now it's only three boards that I managed to use for this. These are the measurements I used. Again, yours is going to be different. It's really going to depend on your railing that you're using. So here is kind of the plan that I hashed out. Now, hopefully this drawing helps you out, but it gives you an idea of the tabletop side, and then the opposite side is the flower planter. So I've left little tiny white lines in between where the wood would actually connect, and this yellow one here on the top I think is one of the most important measurements. You want to make sure that this will sandwich around your railing as tight as possible. So as you can see, I have one board added onto that top piece from underneath and one sits flush with it on the other side. That's just what worked for ours. So you can refer back to this plan, but again, it is going to be different for everyone. I'll do my best to kind of show you how we built this. And I did find that it was really important to do it in this order. What we're doing here is doing some pilot holes with our top piece and the back backboard for our flower pot, or our planter side. So my boyfriend helped me out with this, and we used this little table to kind of make a, you know, a 90 degree joint there, and that was pretty easy to do. Next, we are adding the two side boards for our planter, and again, pilot holes, drilling it into place, making it nice and secure. So now we have that top piece, and we are going to finish off our planter with another 1x10 board. And like I said, I only bought three pieces of wood to make this, so I just made my measurements work. The rest of this board will be used for the tabletop on the other side. So once that was all screwed together, for the bottom, I didn't have this piece of wood in the original picture, but this is just a scrap 1x2 that I had, and I cut it down to size to fit inside of the planter, and this is the bottom. I wanted to leave it open so that any water could drain out and they'd be less likely to rot away. So now we are working on the tabletop side. We're joining our 1x10 with our 1x6 piece. We made it 3 feet long, and again, pilot holes, drilling it in together. So essentially we have these two pieces now, and we are going to join them over top of the railing. We did this literally on the railing, and that is because the tabletop side is shorter than the side with the flower box, so it won't sit flat on the ground in order for us to drill down into the top to add these two pieces together. So thankfully my boyfriend was here to help me out, otherwise there's no way I would have been able to do this project. But again, pilot holes and drilling it all together, and it's really quite stable. It holds a lot, and once you put in the soil on the opposite side, it's gonna help kind of like balance everything out that you put on the table. So I gave this three coats of exterior white paint to match our railing. Make sure you fill in the holes. That is something I forgot to do here, but I did it before I added the other two coats of white paint. Once that dries, we're gonna fill in the bottom here of the planter with some netting fabric, just something light that will hold the soil in place, but obviously allow water to drain out. A weed barrier would work really well for this as well. And then that's it. You can fill it up with soil, planting your favorite plants, my favorite part, and now we have this beautiful planter and tabletop. Thank you. So that's it for my little upgrade to our patio. Let me know if you think this is a good solution for a tight space. You can leave that down in the comments below. And I'm not sure if there's gonna be some other upgrades that I'm going to be making, possibly a bit of a privacy screen. Let me know if that's something you'd like to see me make or if there's any other patio DIYs you'd like to see me do in the future. Leave that down in the comments below. And as always, you can follow me on Instagram and on Twitter at Janelle Steeper. You can tag me in any DIYs that you're trying out at home. I'd love to see what you're making. And that is where you can get sneak peeks of what's coming up on my channel.